Everyone loves a good knockout. It's even better when it comes in the form of an uppercut, considered one of the most brutal and ruthless punches a fighter can land on their opponent. Uppercut is a punch that travels along a vertical line at the opponent's chin or solar plexus and along with a cross, one of the two main punches that count in the statistics as power punches. But when executed perfectly by the right hands, an uppercut could mean the end of the fight for the boxer on the receiving end. Perhaps the best attribute of the said punch is its unpredictability and suddenness. The uppercut, when performed brilliantly, does not announce its bad intentions on the way. It kicks the door open.
Any punches. Uppercut, uppercut.
This video consists of some of the best uppercut knockdowns, knockouts, and just some of the best uppercuts in general, even if they didn't score an extra point or a victory.
Left hook, right hand. Oh!
Press like and notification bell and let's take a look at the top 15 most lethal uppercuts we have ever seen in boxing. George Foreman is arguably the hardest puncher in the history of boxing, and he has this knockout to prove it. Of Foreman's 76 victories, 68 have come by knockout, including his knockout over Jerry Cooney from 1990. In the second round, Foreman dropped Cooney with the two right hands. Cooney made it up for the count, but was knocked out immediately by Foreman's short uppercut. IBF super middleweight champ Roy Jones dispatched former two-time champion Vinnie Pazienza in the sixth with a six-punch flurry Jones initiated and ended with a left uppercut. Jones was on the run when he quickly delivered the final six punches of the fight in this order. Left uppercut, left hook, right hook, right uppercut, left uppercut. Tyson could knock out opponent by any number of punches, including an overhand right and straight right. But when he landed his right uppercut, his opponents would often go down like a redwood in the forest.
Sharp right uppercut to the body by Tyson again.
Lorenzo Boyd gave it his best shot, but he fell victim to a ferocious Tyson, who took him out with a savage uppercut to the chin in round 2 in July of 1986. Filipino fighter and pound-for-pound boxer Nonito Donaire has some of the most powerful uppercuts in the bantamweight division. His 2010 bout versus Hernan Marquez is proof. Donaire is one of the most powerful punchers in the division.
Left hook, right hand. Oh!
He lands a well-timed and accurate uppercut that knocks Hernan down and out for the count. Juan Manuel Marquez is one of the greatest Mexican fighters. His three fights with Manny Pacquiao were some of the best and toughest fights of both fighters' careers.
Buena suerte. Good luck. Let's go.
In his first fight with Juan Diaz, he put on 2009's Fight of the Year and finished off the Baby Bull in round 9. The knockdown Larry Holmes produced over Mike Weaver is one of the heavyweight champion's best punches. In a close and competitive fight, Holmes found an opening in the 11th round and produced a knockdown with an uppercut that led to him winning the fight via TKO in the following round.
That's all.
Tom Johnson attempted to unify his IBF featherweight title with Prince Nassim Hamed's WBO featherweight title in February of 1997 at London Arena. Courageously trying to adjust to Hamed's uncannily awkward style, Johnson was met with awkward power punch after awkward power punch as Hamed shook off every attempt to thwart him.
He doesn't get dizzy. The uppercut.
The end came on one of the dumbest uppercut finishes we've seen land. What Taika Biabucci left us with before being sent to prison in 1999 was 20-0 record and some fan favorite fights, including his fight with David Tua, which holds the record for most punches thrown in a heavyweight bout and 1,730 total punches thrown. His final bout before being imprisoned was a fight with then undefeated Chris Bird. An uppercut in the fifth sent the boxer down, and it wasn't long before he scored the TKO. Jeremy Williams had 9 knockouts in a row, but his opponent Arthur Weathers was hoping to make that come to end. Unfortunately for Weathers, he got dropped just seconds into the bout. The referee called it off just seconds later, giving Williams the 10-second KO. After winning and defending the WBC light heavyweight title 5 times, Matthew Saad Muhammad took on Lati Mowoli. Mowoli was 21-0 at the time. Muhammad ended the bout in the fourth with a perfect one-punch uppercut. Shavers had attempted to win a heavyweight championship but was unsuccessful. Despite Norton's tight defense, Shavers eventually wore him down and knocked him down twice in the fight. The final knockdown came moments after the first, with Shavers sweeping a vicious right uppercut to Norton's face. Lennox Lewis may have possessed the greatest uppercut in the sport. In his fight with Michael Grant, Lewis went up against a boxer who was unbeaten and had been in a candidate for a fight of the year in 1999 versus Andrew Golota. Lewis wasted no time and put the boxer down several times in the bout.
And for the moment, Lewis looked.
He ended the fight in the second round with a remorseless uppercut. In one of the most famous boxing matches ever, undefeated heavyweight George Foreman took on champion Joe Frazier, who was coming off a victory over previously unbeaten Muhammad Ali. Frazier's style was perfect for the power-punching Foreman, and he knocked down the champion 6 times before getting the TKO victory in the second round.
Joe is standing. There he goes.
Frazier was lifted off his feet and landed awkwardly after Foreman delivered that finishing right uppercut. The British boxer won his highly anticipated fight against Vladimir Klitschko, unifying the WBA and IBF heavyweight titles and defended his championship. The fight was a back and forth affair, with Joshua dominating the early rounds before Klitschko made a furious comeback, even putting Joshua down on the mat in the sixth with a big right punch. Joshua slowly regained his senses, his strength, and the grip of his titles, courtesy of a rocketing uppercut in the 11th. James Buster Douglas went into his bout with Mike Tyson as a 42-1 underdog. Douglas had no intentions of not fulfilling his dreams of becoming a heavyweight champion. He would have to do it against the undefeated and most intimidating fighter ever.
Against the ropes, I've never seen.
Douglas went down in round 8. But was able to beat the count, which is also a disputed part of the bout. He returned the favor in the 10th and put Tyson down for the first time in his career.
That will finish things in
uppercut.
What an uppercut by Douglas, and down goes Tyson.
The punch that started it off was the uppercut, and it was a merciless punch.